guys way better.
Namaste. Ascoltando, my dough is homemade and is very fresh.
My dough is more expensive.
Hey, oh, the money does not make the dough taste any better.
Oh, I went to work and spent all my time to get that money for the amazing dough.
Come to Paris. Italians don't go to the store and buy dough. That's what lazy people do.
Yeah, well, at least I'm making life easier.
Chicos, put some effort into your life. Just lazy.
At least I made my own fresh mozzarella.
Well, my cheese tastes like heaven and yours most likely sucks.
Oh, mamma mia, why are we even fighting about this stupid pizza?
Hey, my pizza is not stupid, it's your pizza is stupid, it tastes like trash.
That's it, though. What do you know what trash tastes like?
I found out what trash tastes like after I ate your pizza.
Hey, YouTube world, how's it going? Today we've got unbiased review just for the sake of argument. We're gonna take a look at these two Italian brands, pretty much your mainstream boot for trials riding. We've got Gaerne's here, the balance oiled boot, and we've got the Alpinestars Trials Tech boot. Both of them are pretty much the same price point. Big differences depending on what you wanna do when you ride your trials bike. All right, price point. There is a big difference though. These Garnier boots, the oil ones, you probably have about 3 to 4 different versions, and it'll range from $300 to the $520, which is these ones pretty much top of the line. Alpinestars, $500. They are on sale right now at $499 for $370. That's a bargain. That's a great price. Very different boot sizes. So if you're a regular, I'm a regular US 11, pretty much everything I buy fits really well. These ones are a true fit, and these read 46 euro 11 US. White toe box on these ones, so if you got a wider foot, this boot is perfect. These ones are US 11, reads here euro 45 and a half. Toe box is a little bit narrower, but it's taller. It's kind of weird riding in them at first, because it doesn't, you cannot cinch them down here with a buckle, so it feels like my foot's got a little bit of play in there. These ones are definitely a nicer fit than these. If you wear thicker socks, you can probably make up the difference for the Alpinestars. Key features between these two, these are waterproof boots. They're advertised as waterproof boots. After a few rides, you gotta apply mink oil to them if you wanna keep the waterproofness. The leather stays in good shape. These are a bit dirty and dried out. 60 hours of use on these ones. I've got 30 hours on these ones. So we've got a membrane, a Dri-Tech membrane on the inside. It's actually super comfy. Very smooth, it's hard to see on the camera. So that is a breathable material. You don't sweat in them. You can ride all summer. They feel absolutely amazing. The Alpinestars, it's more of your regular dirt bike boot, membrane on the inside. We'll just open these up. I do find them a little bit warmer in the summer. My feet sweat a little more, not as breathable. So we talked about the key features on the Gaerne's. So waterproof, breathable membrane in the inside, very soft sole, very grippy. It's soft, it's gonna wear out. You can see it's quite a bit of wear from the foot peg. So not a whole lot to break for the Gaerne's when it comes to protection. They're a softer type of boot. This is where the Alpinestars, they shine a bit more. You've got a more robust sole on this one with a heavy duty tread. You do also have built-in plate on your ankle supports. So overall, this boot has better ankle support than the Gaerne's. You do have a toe cap that is a protector for your shifter and the brake pedal. So that is an awesome feature on these boots. So you might say, okay, well, I'm gonna buy the boots that feel like they have the most protection. No, you're not gonna think that way, because I broke my ribs because of these boots. Out of the box, these boots, the Gaerne's, are phenomenal. They are broken in pretty much the first time you wear them. They get a little bit softer over time, but they're ready to go out of the box. You can step on the rocks with them. They've got flex, fantastic boots. You don't have to worry about breaking them in. They do get softer over time. That is the downside. These ones are very stiff for out of the box. So 30 hours in these boots and they're just starting to feel right. They feel good, yet they still feel like they have protection. These boots, I broke my ribs. I was standing on the rock, very first day, trying to get used to them and to a brand new bike. Standing on the rock, holding my bike up like this. And both of the toe caps, I'm used to these ones. I was trying to grip into the rocks and push my bike up. I kind of screwed up a line. Both of these toe caps gave out traction and I belly flopped on the rock, slid down, broke the left side of my ribs. It was freaking the most painful 2 months recovery or even more as I kept riding. So that was quite terrible. So that's what you would expect out of these. So yeah, you might buy them and think, listen, I'm gonna have more protection, but be aware that you might slip. You're not gonna feel your controls as well as the Gaernes. So that is the downside to them. The protection on the actual foot part is amazing. I love it. The feeling is not quite the same as these ones. You can feel your bike really well on the Gaernes versus the Alpinestars. The wear. So this is the sole. 30 hours on this sole is holding up really well. So it's a little bit harder material, harder rubber, the Gaernes. We've got 60 hours. I would say the hardness is almost the same. So it's starting to get chewed up on the arch a little bit more. So another big difference that you would have between the two boots is the buckle system. And let me explain to you, this buckle system, you've got pretty much every buckle, it's pointing into a different direction. You've got this one pointing this way. This buckle goes around to the back. And this buckle is again pointing this way. It's kind of weird trying to cinch down the lower buckle because it feels like when you close it, it's pinching on top of your foot. And then after you move around for, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes, the boot settles down and finds its home. All of the Gaernes buckles, they're all facing one direction. And that really helps the boot line up on this overflap. Everything lines up nicely. You're not forcing anything the opposite way. It's laying in one direction. Another big key, and it's, I wish, I don't know if there is a patent on these buckles, I'm sure there is. Gaernes buckles have been my favorite buckles ever since I started wearing the boots for dirt bikes. You've got a very robust system. You've got your replaceable strap and then a full size buckle. So it goes over the pivot point and clips in, and it's got a cam. It feels like it locks in. It's not gonna pop open. Stays in solid. I love it. I wish I could combine these buckles with the Alpinestars. Alpinestars, on the other hand, you have a weird little T-shaped slot. So you got a T-shaped buckle. It goes into a slot from the front. And then you have to make sure that the buckle sits low enough and it clips in and closes. It does have a chance to move up and down. And as you can see right now, it's actually not lined up. So when you're putting the boots on, you're kind of having to, especially for me, I got thicker calves. You have to force the lever of the buckle up and down just so your arm lines up with the slot. And it's not fun. You're putting, especially when they're brand new, they're so stiff, it's not fun. So that is one of those takeaway things. If you're buying the Alpinestars, you're gonna have a long break-in period, so you're not gonna feel comfortable on them. And you have a bit of an annoying buckle system. Overall, the boot is awesome. I love it. And these ones are still my favorite I don't wear them riding as much anymore unless I'm riding with the kid or I'm doing trail work. Matter of fact, actually, they are awesome for hiking. So when I do trail work, I'm hiking on a mountain or riding with a kid, just general walking around, and sometimes you do have to walk around quite a bit with trials. These win. I don't trust these ones. They're not comfortable all day in them. Your feet get sore. They're so stiff. You know, they've broken in a bit now. It's not the same. The protection, 100%. 100%, these are more protective. You're going to fall into a hole. You got any kind of rocks. This is what you want to have. You don't want to break your ankle. And these ones are good from new over time. They soften up a bit. I haven't applied mink oil on them for a few rides now. But you can see they're fairly well worn and they're amazing. They almost look like retro trials boots that you would use in a vintage trial. Actually would go well with the Honda right here behind me. I got a TLR 200, the Reflex. So these are my favorite boots there. I just thought of something. If you're a dual sporter, I think the dual sporters will love these. They're absolutely perfect for dual sporting. So that is one more bonus on the Alpinestars. They're on sale right now at $4.99, good price. So another great point that we need to cover is the shin protection. So even though the Gaernes, they have quite a thick piece of plastic built into their shin protector, I find the Alpinestars a little bit beefier. Maybe it's because they've got ridges on the letters for their logo here, but the Gaernes are they're generally a taller shin protector versus the Alpinestars. And we'll grab the tape measure. Okay, so we need to know this. Alpinestars are at pretty much 4.5 inches and Gaernes are 5.5 inches. So you've got an inch extra of shin protection on the Gaernes. That will make a big difference when you smack into something, that's for sure. I hope you enjoyed the review. I'm gonna try to do more gear reviews in the future. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you on the next one.